Welcome to Positive Atheism English Channel. Today, from the book The Life and Times of Gora, written by Mark Lindley, I am going to read out the chapter 6, Moving to a Larger Village Near a City. In 1946, internal Congress elections were held, now that everyone was out of jail, for provincial committees throughout India. In Mudunur, a low caste faction supported Gora, but a larger middle and a high caste faction supported his original host there, who was of course native to the village. This competition prompted Gora to look for a new location for the atheist center. Early in 1947, he toured Telugu-speaking areas to promote social reform to local Congress members. This was in keeping with Gandhi's idea, which was never accepted by the Congress politicians, that the Congress ought now to transform itself into a rural constructive work organization rather than a political party. In some of these talks, Gora mentioned that he was hoping to shift the atheist center from Mudunur, which was some 20 kilometers from the nearest town. Vijayawada had no marketplace, was generally muddy, and had poor communications with the rest of the world, to a more accessible place. The host of a talk he gave in the village of Patamata, which was in those days about 3 kilometers from Vijayawada, responded by inviting the atheist center there. The shift in April 1947 was to a farmer mango grove owned by a Brahmin who offered the land for this purpose. No new materials were needed for new huts. His folks from Mudunur helped dismantle the old ones, pack the materials in a couple of trucks, and rebuild the huts at Patamata. Before long, the atheists were evicted from this site because its owner disapproved of Manorama's marriage, even though he had approved of the cosmopolitan dinners. But the village had frustrated this intent by donating some of his own land at the atheist center, has remained at that site ever since. The brother of the new donor married Vijaya in 1950. Patamata was a rural place until the 1980s, but today is well within Vijayawada, which has grown to a city of a million inhabitants. Gora's and Saraswati's ninth and last child, a daughter named Nau, that means nine, was born in November 1947. Soon afterwards, he heard about a method of sterilization with practically no side effects, vasectomy, and adopted it. He was 45 years old, Saraswati 35. It was in August of 1947 that India became no longer a colony in the British Empire, but like Australia and Canada, a republic and an independent dominion in the British Commonwealth. However, for about a year afterwards, there was some doubt whether certain large parts would be provinces of India called states after independence. Kashmir, the people of which were 80% Muslims but were ruled by a Hindu Maharaj, is still today problematic. Just as large and rich as Kashmir was the state of Hyderabad, the people of which were more than 90% Hindus but were ruled by a Muslim Nizam whose wife was the daughter of the former Sultan of the Ottoman Empire. The Nizam of Hyderabad, who had no wish to cede his realm to the Republic of India, was renowned for his wealth and well known for his disregard of the welfare of most of the population. More than half of them were Telugu speaking and lived in a region called Telangana. In 1947-48, Gora was active as the vice chairman of a committee of assistance, fundraising, resettling refugees, and training young people to fight in an underground army to a liberation movement among refugees from the Telangana. This movement strengthened the hand of India's tough Minister of the Interior, Patel, in persuading the Nizam in 1948 to yield to the Indian government. Some government police action also helped. About a tenth of the refugee families in Vijayawada became atheists and, upon returning home, started an atheist center in Telangana. Some of the young people who had become acquainted with Gora in the liberation struggle then helped in the other activities, including organizing tours of the Telangana with cosmopolitan dinners and talks condemning superstitions, advocating atheism, and promoting social equality and economic justice. In 1948, the Atheist Center bought a used printing press of 19th century vintage with some type fonts in English as well as Telugu. By November, it was unpacked and set up, and in January 1949, it began to publish a journal and some books. At first, Gora would spend 4 days each week on the journal, which was entitled Sangam, meaning society, and subtitled Atheist Telugu Weekly. He also lectured here and there in Andhra throughout 1949 and then in 1950 began to delegate some of his editorial work to Lavanam so as to have time to write his most beautiful book, An Atheist with Gandhi, and to give talks in other South Indian provinces and in Maharashtra. The main themes of the talks were the gradual but deliberating dismantling of the caste system by intermarriages, a gradual reduction of economic inequalities, and the immediate abandonment of the custom of dowries. Dowries had traditionally been a kind of substitute for daughters inheriting directly from their fathers, but Nehru insisted on a new law that theoretically entitled daughters, albeit only under system circumstances, to inherit just like their brothers, and after that, dowries tended to become just a way for the groom's family to extract money from the bride's family. Still today, one reads every so often in the newspapers in India some report of a young wife's death in an accidental fire in the kitchen because she has not succeeded in getting her parents to satisfy her in-laws' demand of a large dowry than the one delivered at the time of the wedding. In 1950, Gora met at a public meeting where they were both on the dais, a very distinguished Telugu poet, Joshua Gurram, who was an astonishing thing in those days for a poet and untouchable. They became friends and in 1951 decided that Lavanam, who was by now 20 years old, ought to marry Joshua's youngest daughter, Hemalatha, who was 17. They did marry, but not until 10 years later, since Lavanam preferred to remain single for a while yet. In 1950-51, Gora took up the cause of some 100 families of untouchable cobblers who were being made homeless in Vijayawada. For many years, they had been employed by Muslim tannery owners who had always provided them with housing on the tannery land, but who in 1948 had sold their holdings and migrated to Pakistan. The new owners of the land served eviction notices. Gora asked them to let the families remain, but they refused, so he organized the families to occupy and build huts on the edges of a little used road nearby. However, this road was near an upmarket and neighborhood where the homeowners objected to having a nearby slum. So the city ordered the demolition of the huts. Gora prevented it by squatting for a week together with his wife and the cobblers and their families in front of the huts to prevent them from the being turned down, and meanwhile initiating negotiations with the municipal and district authorities. The tactic worked, and after long negotiations, the cobblers were allowed to stay legally until the provincial government eventually gave them, in the mid-1960s, proper housing elsewhere in the city. This was the first urban land grant program in that part of India, and it influenced the provincial government to adopt a policy of not having squatters evicted from the government-owned land until alternate sites for their housing could be provided. Thank you. We'll meet in the next episode again.
Please download Samaram Multichannel app and watch your favorite channels from your mobile. App available on Google Play Store and subscribe to the channels. For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.